Good evening, ladies and gents, and welcome back to the Braindead Breakdown. And today we're going back to Slaughter to Prevail. Bonebreaker this time, live in Moscow. Only liked one of the three songs of theirs that I've checked out so far. And whilst they haven't been up to my speed, I have still pointed out how I very much respect the musicianship. I very much respect Alex and the drums and everything. It's like obviously really talented. And one of the comments recommended I check out Bonebreaker live in Moscow. And I thought that was a very good idea because live normally gets across the talent way better than a studio recording. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to check that out right now. I like the riff already. Very doom. I like it. Very doom. Very, very doom. Like, it reminds me of like doom, the doom, it's like the Mick Gordon riffs. And like, I could just imagine like bunny hopping around hell, bopping demons to that. All right. Let's continue. Now look at those guys, everyone in that crowd's having the fucking time of their life, look at them. I still love the aesthetic of this band as well, like the general aesthetic and like the masks and it's great. I think like they're very, I love the effort they put into their presentation, it's really good. I like this. I picked the wrong two songs to start on this band with. And someone said in the comments that particularly the one that I was most critical of was a response to people saying that they'd sold out with 1984. So they went like super heavy and just, it was like a response to that. So that's why there's like basically no riffs, no guitar melody. It's just boom, but the whole way through. Whereas this, like, I like this. I like, this is like, I should have started with this. I should have started closer to the beginning. Like, when was this uploaded? A year ago. Okay. But I don't know how old Bonebreaker is, but yeah, I just got unlucky. I'd say like now, that's the thing, right? Now that I've started it, I'm starting to get recommendations, which are helping. Whereas when I started doing this, like the first ones I picked were just completely blind. Like I'd seen Alex on social media and thought, oh my God, this dude's a beast. I need to check it out. And yeah, I got unlucky. I picked the wrong ones because I'm into this. I love this. I'm enjoying this.
We want them, they give you food.
I'm not surprised the drummer is in amazing shape. Like, it just cuts him, because I was just thinking, man, this drummer's probably ruined by the end of these gigs. And then it cuts to him and he is like a fucking god. Like, I mean, Alex is like in, like, obviously ripped as well, but the drummer looks like an absolute god as well. No wonder he'd have to be, like, because Jesus Christ, like, that's doing this every night, man. Like, man, yeah, he's probably sweating his balls off, he's knackered, you know, but and no one is safe. What do you think? Did you make me class? Round you pay, round you dance. Don't look ahead, but I cover your back. What provoked me? Who's provoked me? You look ahead, but I cover your back. What can they do with the things they get you from me? What do you think? You're so brave. The time comes and no one is safe. What do you think? Did you make me class? Doesn't matter at all. Fuck yeah. Well, leave a like to that. Sub to Alex as well. He deserves a sub. Right. Well, I'm sorry. I'm just currently trying to gather my thoughts. You know, that looked like a fucking immense concert to be at. Like, everyone in that crowd looked like they was having the time of their life. As usual, Alex killed it. The drummer, I need to find out the drummer's name. All right, let's look up the drummer's name. Their current drummer is... Evgeny Novikov. Apologies if I'm butchering your name, but I at least had to give it a go, because like the drums in those songs, respect Mr. Novikov. But yeah, Mr. Novikov. We've got Alex Terrible. We've got Mike on bass. Jack Simmons on lead. And Dmitry Dima Mamedov on rhythm. Well, respect to the lads, because like I say, they look like they put on an absolutely insane concert. The vibe of their concerts looks like it's great. Like, brilliant show. And just great aesthetic. I'd say that might, that's, I would put this song at number two out of the ones I've listened to so far. Definitely, definite number two. Apparently the song that I like the most is the one that most people said they sold out on. So, if you're a Slaughter to Prevail fan, I am sorry, but we all have different opinions, we all have different tastes. I'm trying. I'm getting there. I have been brain dead. Like the video if you liked it. Dislike it if you didn't. Subscribe for more like this. And I'll catch you in the next one. Peace.